Hi, this is Andrew Park, and this is part one of a couple of videos on how to write an executive summary for research purposes and for grant proposals, by the way, because I see some commonalities between them. I want to go over what an executive summary is and what it is not. An executive summary is a document that is easy to understand, and that's kind of the most important thing, because if it's not easy to understand, it's a waste of time. So it's easy to understand, it's accessible, and it stands on its own. In other words, it can be read instead of the entire rest of the study. So an executive summary is instead of the rest of your document. It is not an abstract. It's not an overview of the contents of your study. It's not supposed to help the reader decide whether they're going to read the rest of your study. An abstract would do that, but this is not that. So it should stand on its own. Now, one of the things that I like to call an executive summary is an executive selection, because there is this tendency of people to think that an executive summary should have some little bits of language and phrases in there that relate to every single part of the study or the proposal or whatever you're summarizing. That's going to result in an executive summary that is written at a very higher level of altitude, a higher level of generalization. It's not going to be vivid. It's not going to give specific information. What you need to do is have an executive summary where you select, that's why I call it an executive selection, where you select the best findings and the most compelling findings from your survey, put those in your executive summary, leave the rest of the stuff out, and save it for the other materials having to do with your research. So you want to keep it vivid and specific. You also want some language in there that relates it to the larger issue for which you're advocating. And you might want to actually kind of emphasize a little more language dealing with a call to action and what should people do now that they know the summary of this research. So in the other videos, I'm going to talk about how you can test your executive summary to see if you've written it specifically enough, and I want to go over some examples as well.